In this video, you'll see how you can build a Python event-driven serverless application with Amazon CodeWhisperer. With this machine learning-powered service, you can build applications faster by leveraging code recommendations and implementing API calls across popular AWS services. This is the application that we're going to build with the help of Amazon CodeWhisperer. Users will have two different URLs they can interact with to download and recognize objects and images. To achieve this implementation, we'll work with four different lambda functions. We'll begin by implementing a lambda function that downloads an image using a provided URL and then uploads the image to Amazon S3. For demonstration purposes, we've already prepared an application with the AWS Cloud Development Kit, or AWS CDK. We are using Visual Studio Code as our IDE, but we could also use an IDE by JetBrains. To get started, let's navigate to our first lambda function. CodeWhisperer supports several programming languages, including Java, JavaScript, and Python. In this example, we'll use Python to build our application. Let's type a comment that says, write a function to download a file from http:get and press enter. CodeWhisperer guesses our intent and suggests a function name. We'll accept the suggestion by using our tab key. Next, let's press enter to see CodeWhisperer's suggestions for the body of the function. We'll use our right arrow key to continue through the suggestions until we find the one we want to use. We'll press tab to select this one. Next, let's call the function and pass it the image to recognize and image file name variables. Now we need to upload the image to Amazon S3. To do this, we'll enter a comment. We'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestion to name the function upload file. We'll also accept the suggested method. Now let's call this function and pass it the image file name and our S3 bucket. We've finished our first lambda function. All we had to do was type in our text comments, and CodeWhisperer generated the code for us. Now we'll implement our second lambda function. This function will read an item from the Amazon Simple Queue Service, or SQS queue, use Amazon Recognition to recognize all the labels from the image, store the results in Amazon DynamoDB, and then publish the results to Amazon Simple Notification Service, or SNS. Let's start by entering Receive Message from SQS. We'll use the method suggested by CodeWhisperer. Next, we'll define the image event as Receive Message and set MyQURL as the parameter. Now, let's enter Detect Labels from Image with Recognition. We'll accept the suggested name, which requires a bucket and key. We'll also accept the suggested implementation, which will return all the labels that are in the image. Next, let's define labels as Detect Labels and pass the image bucket and key. Now, let's enter Save Item to DynamoDB. We'll accept the suggested name and choose our preferred implementation. In this case, CodeWhisperer took into consideration our prior code that recognizes images from recognition when creating a format and structure for the items that will be saved. Let's rename the method and provide the image ID as a parameter. We'll also rename a couple of the parameters. Before calling this method, we need to import the UUID module. Let's call the method and pass it a random UUID and the detected label. Now we need to send the image to SNS. When we press enter, CodeWhisperer suggests adding code to send a message. The suggestion looks good, but instead of sending the image event, we'll send the labels. Now let's define the method. We'll enter Publish Item to SNS. CodeWhisperer makes assumptions about the message, the subject, and the message attributes. The assumptions look good, so we'll accept this suggestion. Finally, let's add code to delete the message from SQS so we don't process it twice. We'll call delete message and pass the appropriate parameters. The second lambda function is now complete. Now we'll implement a third lambda function. This function will read the object from the Amazon SQS queue that was published by the previous lambda function. It will then convert the message from JSON to XML and send the message to an external email server. Let's start by entering receive message from SQS. We'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestions. Next, let's create a variable called SQSQURL and assign a value to it. Let's also create a variable called processedImage and set it to our receiveMessage method, passing the SQSQURL variable as a parameter. When we press Enter, CodeWhisperer guesses what we want to do next. In this case, it's exactly right. We want to convert JSON to XML. Let's set up the method. We'll continue through CodeWhisperer's suggestions until we find a method we like. Now we need to send the XML message to our email server using HTTP POST. Again, CodeWhisperer guesses what we want to do. Instead of accepting CodeWhisperer's suggestion, we'll enter send XML object with HTTP POST to define the method first. Now let's call the method and pass it the appropriate parameters. Next, we'll define a method to delete the message from SQS. Finally, let's call the method. Now we'll implement our fourth lambda function. This function reads all the items from the DynamoDB table and returns them as JSON objects. Let's open the lambda function. Currently, all this function does is scan items from DynamoDB. We'll enter list all items from a DynamoDB table to get suggestions from CodeWhisperer. Let's choose the name scanTable. This method includes all the items we want. We can return the items by simply calling the method and passing the table as a parameter. Based on our comments written in plain natural language, CodeWhisperer generated code that matches our patterns and style without requiring us to spend time researching methods. Now, let's test this application with this image of a pug to see what it recognizes. We'll invoke the endpoint that we just deployed and then pass the URL for the image. The image uploaded successfully. Now we'll invoke the second API gateway endpoint to see the results. The application labeled our pug image tiger, wildlife, animal, mammal, canine, pet, dog, and so on, proving that our application with the code generated by CodeWhisperer is up and running. You've just seen how to build a Python event-driven serverless app with Amazon CodeWhisperer. You can learn more about this topic and sign up for the CodeWhisperer preview in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.